Coming to the next slide, that is similarity and dissimilarity measures. In clustering tech, similarity and dissimilarity measure is very, very important measurement. Informally, similarity between two objects. What are two objects? Two objects may be two images, or they may be two points in the 2D space. There may be two documents, there may be two strings, there may be two records, and so on. Is a numerical measure of the degree to which two objects are alike, they are similar, where the distance between them should be very less. What is dissimilarity? It is exactly opposite of similarity. It is an alternative measure of the degree to which two objects are different. So if you want to find the dissimilarity measure, it means you have to find out the largest distance between two points. Both similarity and dissimilarity are also termed as proximity measures. They are also termed as proximity measures. Usually, similarity or dissimilarity are always non-negative numbers. Means whenever we talk about the term distance, distance never been negative. It is always positive, correct? So that's why similarity and dissimilarity measures are related to distance measure. They must not be negative numbers. They must be always positive. Range from zero. Now the value of this dissimilarity and similarity measure may vary in the range of zero to any some finite number or infinite number. It may go to up to infinity, but it is always in positive side. Note, frequently the term distance is used as a synonym for dissimilarity. In fact, it is used to refer as a special case of dissimilarity. Now, suppose I want to find the proximity measure for a single attribute. Then how to obtain the dissimilarity matrix for a single attribute, we'll see now. Consider an object which is defined by a single attribute A. Attribute may be any entity attribute. It may be name, roll number, right, email ID. So here one example they have given, it is considered as length. You can see any attribute. And the attribute A has n distinct values. So you can say it is the domain of that attribute. What is domain? It is set of permutable values into the attribute. So the values inside the attribute A are A1, A2, up till AN. So a data structure called as dissimilarity matrix can also be used to store the collection of proximity data available for all pairs of n attributes. So if I compare this attribute A with another attribute, then I can find the similarity or dissimilarity between two attributes, and that can be obtained into a dissimilarity matrix as follows. In other words, the dissimilarity matrix for attribute A with value n is represented by the following matrix, and square matrix, that is n by n matrix. As now you can see, the diagonal elements are zeros. The distance between that particular point, 0 to 0, suppose if you give indices here on the rows at 0, 1, 2, 3 up to n, similarly you give indices on the columns at 0, 1, 2, 3, up to, suppose, again, n, right? So what is this 0 representing? It is a point where P00 is calculated. P of 00 distance is always 0. The next one is P of 11 is also 0. P of 22 is 0. P of 33 is 0, and so on till P of nn is 0. The point where P of 21 is written here, this calculates the proximity distance between the point 2, 1. This P of 31 is nothing but the proximity measure for a point P of 3, 1, and so on. Remember that the distance between the same point, means 1 to 1, is always 0. 0 to 0 is always 0. 3 to 3 is always 0. That's why you can see the diagonal elements where the same point is there. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 are there. All distances are 0. Here, P of ij denotes the proximity measure between two objects with attribute values A and ij. The proximity measure can be symmetric if and only if P of ij measure value is equals to the P of ji value. It means that p of 1 2 suppose if you take the example of p of 1 2 value is equals to p of 2 1 right. So if those values are matching, we can say that these two points are symmetric, otherwise they are dissymmetric. How do you calculate the proximity measures? How do you calculate the value of PIG? Proximity calculation to compute PIG is different for different types of attributes according to NOIR topology. Now, nominal attributes, there are different types of attributes, maybe nominal attribute, maybe binary, maybe numerical value, and so on. So, first one is the nominal attribute, like gender. Gender can be male or female, where male is represented by binary 1, whereas female is represented by 0. If the gender is male, it is represented by 1. If it is female, it is represented by 0. The similarity value is 1. If the two objects contain the same attribute value, if both are male into a point, proximity point, then we can say that the answer is 1. If both are female, also the answer is 1. And if they are different, one is male and another is female, then the answer should be 0. See this? The similarity value is 1 if two objects contain the same attribute value, while the similarity value is 0, which implies that objects are not at all similar. If there are two males, answer is 1. If there are two female, answer is 1. And for other combinations of input, like one is male and another is female, output must be 0. One is female, another is male, then again the output must be 0. To understand this, just consider the table given here. The two column, one is object and another is gender. Or you can say the name of the persons are given here, Ram, Sita and Lakshman. Here, Ram is male, Sita is female and Lakshman is male. You can see on the right side of this, proximity measure for Ram, Sita, it must be 0 because these two objects are different. One is male and another is female. That's why the answer is 0 for this. Proximity measure for these two objects is 0. Now, the second example where both are male, one is Ram and another is Lakshman, both are male, they are similar, we can say that the output is 1 for them. Like this, we can calculate the proximity measure for nominal attributes. We can say similarity. What is that proximity measure? In other words, it is also called as similarity measure. Now, suppose I want to calculate the dissimilarity measure for any attribute, then how to calculate it? Always remember this note given here. If Q denotes the dissimilarity between two objects I and J with single attribute, binary attributes, then Q of I, J is equals to 1 minus P of I, J. Now what is this? Q of I, J is the similarity value, whereas P of I, J is the similarity value. If you add similarity and dissimilarity value, your answer is always 1. If you add similarity value as well as dissimilarity value, if you add these two components, your answer is always 1. Now, if I want to find only the similarity component from it, I will apply this formula. It is dissimilarity value is nothing but 1 minus similarity value. You just have to remember this. Whenever we need to find something, we need to find dissimilarity between two objects. So this formula can be applied on that. Now we'll see another example where we want to find the proximity just between two objects which are defined by two or more binary values, binary attributes. Consider, now it is not shown here actually in this table. There are two objects. On row side, the object X is there, and on column side, the object Y is there. Okay, assume that it is there. Object Y is here on the column side. Then how I can obtain the contingency table with binary attributes? For one binary object, there are two possibilities of binary bits, that is 1 and 0. So I'll write 1 and 0 on the row side. Similarly, for object on the column side, I will also write 1 1 0. Then to obtain the contingency matrix, like I can write here in scale of 1 1, the intersection of this row and this column, that value becomes f of 1 1. F of 1 1, the number of attributes between attributes where x is 1 and y is 1, that value will come here into this intersection point. Another value is 1 0. Immediate next cell you will find it is f of 1 0, that value will be placed here. And this is the number of attributes where x is 1 and y is 0. Then third cell here, where x is 0 and y is 1, it is the number of attributes where x is 0 and y is 1. What is f of 0 0? It will be our last cell of this contingency matrix. Here f of 0 0 is the number of attributes where x is 0 and y is also 0. Now remember this formula. You have to add all these values, f of 0 0 to f of 1 1, to get the value b, the total number of binary attributes in a given table. Now two cases may arise. This attribute can be asymmetric or it can be symmetric value. Now what is asymmetric? Their binary value is different. Then such attributes are called as asymmetric attributes. If the binary values are same, then it is called as symmetric. So in the above example, which are the symmetric values here? F 11, F 00 is considered as symmetric, whereas F 10 and 01 are asymmetric. Now this is important. How to calculate the similarity matrix for binary attributes? Similarity measures with symmetric binary attributes. To measure the similarity between two objects defined by symmetric binary attributes, using a measure is called as symmetric binary coefficient, and it is always denoted by the symbol delta. It is always denoted by the symbol delta, and the formula that we use to calculate this measure is delta equals to number of matching attributes values divided by total number of attributes available. Number of matching attributes, remember this thing. Numerator point is number of matching attributes. Which are those in the above example? They are F00 and F11. They are F00 and F11, where the attribute value x and y both are matching, divided by number of attributes in the given matrix. So which are those? Addition of all these F00, F01, F10, F1. That has to be written in the formula, in the denominator. Right. Now similarly, I can calculate. This is delta is for similarity binary coefficient. And if I want to find the dissimilarity measure for this example, I will use the same similar type of formula. D equal to, suppose D is used for dissimilarity measure, I will use the formula D equal to number of mismatch attributes values. So here numerator, check, the numerator is different now. Number of mismatch attribute values divided by number of attributes. So the denominator is same, only the numerator is changing here. And here we need to find which are the attributes. They are dissimilar in the above table. Dissimilar attributes are f of 10 and f of 01. You can see here F01 plus F10 is written. They are dissimilar, divided by total number of attributes present. Like this, we can calculate the similarity matrix for binary attributes. So here we seen both the formulas, one for calculating the similarity matrix and another is for calculating the dissimilarity matrix. This also can be written as, dissimilarity can also be written as 1 minus delta. D equal to 1 minus delta. That formula we have seen before also. Dissimilarity equal to 1 minus similarity. We'll see one example to understand for more than one attributes of binary, how this binary symmetric attributes can be measured, can be obtained. Now consider one database is given to you, where there are columns like gender, food, caste, education, hobby, and job. In gender, there are two values in the set, that is, it may be male or female. In food category, we have two values, that is vegetarian and non-vegetarian. In caste, it is Hindu or Muslim. In education, it is literate or illiterate. In hobby, it may be tennis or cricket. Then job, whether that person has job, yes or no. If the person has a job, the value is yes. If he does not have the job, the value is no. And okay, now assume that the table has been given to you and your job is to find the symmetric measure for this table. Check the objects given to you. Objects means the person, and then the other attributes like gender, food, caste, education, hobby and job. Here the similarity matrix for the two objects like Hari and Ram can be obtained by, what is the formula for calculating the similarity matrix? The number of attributes where the values are same for these two records, Hari and Ram, find the number of attributes where the values are same. Which are those attributes? You can see gender is same, caste is same, the last job is same. You just add all this, that is, so your numerator become 3 and denominator is nothing but number of attribute values in that. So how many attributes are there? Total 6, correct? There are 6 attributes. So I'll write 6 in the denominator and the total answer become 3/6. We get 0.5. Now my question to you, all of you, is now find, your job is to find the similarity matrix between Hari and Tommy. All of you just solve this. Hari and, what is the similarity measure between Hari and Tommy? You can write your answer in the chat box. Yes, let me check. One student has given the answer, I think. Arjun is saying it is 2/6. All of you, please write your answer in the chat box. This is very, very important from your exam point of view. How to calculate this similarity matrix? This type of question may be asked for 5 marks in the exam, final exam. One example is given on the slide, that is delta, that is similarity matrix of Hari, Ram can be obtained as numerator is nothing but the attributes where the values of Hari and Ram are same, and it is divided by the total attributes of this row. That is, see here, gender is male, both are male, right? Caste also same, as well as job also same. I can say there are 3 values which are matching, divided by total number of values in that row. So how many values are there in the row? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I will divide it by 6. 3/6 is 0.5. Now your job is to find the similarity matrix for the two objects, Hari and Tommy. Please write your answer in the chat box. Only one student has given the answer, is Arjun. And he is saying the answer is 2/6. Yes, Parit, very good. Jitesh is saying also 2/6. Jess is saying 2/6. So I can say that most of you are saying 2/6. That's why the answer is correct. Tana is saying it is also 2/6. I want all of you to just check the slide and then give your answer. You can solve it in the notebook and then you can write. What is 2/6? It is 1/3. And if you calculate in terms of the solution, it must be 0 point something, correct? 1/3 is 0.33. Jitesh Singh, 0.33. Good. All are right. Any questions, student, till this point? If you have any questions, please write in the chat box. I'll take the attendance in between. No questions? Okay. We'll now move to the next point of similarity measures, calculation of similarity measures. The next important point is how to calculate the proximity measure for asymmetric binary attributes. For that, we can use Jaccard coefficient to calculate the proximity measure for asymmetric binary attributes. We can use Jaccard coefficient. We're going to see all these distances, all these examples of Jaccard coefficient in the next lecture. But in this particular topic, again, the Jaccard coefficient was mentioned. That's why we'll see just an introduction of Jaccard coefficient. It is a similarity measure between two objects defined by asymmetric binary attributes, and it is done by Jaccard coefficient represented by J, given by J. And the equation for finding the Jaccard coefficient is equal to number of matching presents divided by number of attributes not involved in zero-zero matching. It means it is similar to the finding the proximity between asymmetric binary values, but only one thing is different in this formula is that we have to write everything except F00, except F00 matching. So number of attributes not involved in 0-0 matching should be written at the denominator, and numerator is number of matching presence where your two attribute values are same. Now to understand this, I'll go back to the previous table. Here you can see this F11, F10, F01 and F00. We have to exclude this F00 in the formula of calculating Jaccard coefficient, and we have to consider only F01, F10 and F11, and we have to put the values inside that formula, correct, to find the Jaccard coefficient. And the formula becomes J equal to F11 divided by F01 plus F10 plus F11. Now one example again to find that the same example is taken here that we have seen before, but here we are going to find out the Jaccard coefficient. It means obtaining the proximity measure for asymmetric binary. In the example before that we have seen, there we found delta coefficient, that was for finding the proximity measures for symmetric binary. Here it is asymmetric binary. To find the asymmetric binary proximity measure, we use Jaccard coefficient. The same data is given to you: the gender attribute, food, caste, education, hobby, and job is given. I already explained you what is these values inside these sets, and the table is also same given to you. And your job is to find now the Jaccard coefficient of Hari, Ram. Now check the number of attributes where the presence of both the objects is same, excluding 0-0 matching. Male is 1 and female is 0. Correct. So the component where we found the values are matching, it is considered as 1, and total number of attributes where they are not matching, except 0-0. So there are 4. And the value becomes 1 by 4 and the answer is 0.25. Jaccard coefficient for Ram and Tommy is 0. Jaccard coefficient for Hari and Ram is equal to Jaccard coefficient of Ram, Hari. It is obviously the Jaccard coefficient must be same because it is considered as x, y and y, z. Jaccard coefficient for x, y and Jaccard coefficient for y, x, you can say. Then they are same. Now we move to the topic where we have this very important properties of proximity measures for internal scale. To find the internal distance between two points, the measure called distance is usually referred to estimate the similarity between two objects defined with internal scaled attribute. We first represent a generic formula to express distance d between two objects x comma y in n-dimensional space. Suppose x and y denotes the values of ith attribute of the objects x and y respectively, then the total distance between x and y is equals to, it is summation of all the points x minus y z, means all the differences x I minus y z. It's a determinant always. Why is the determinant is given here? Because the distance is always positive. It should not be negative. So in the summation, we are adding all the different points between x and y, their differences, and we are taking the determinant of it. Rest to r, and power of this entire bracket is 1 upon r, where r is the integer value. This distance matrix is mostly known as Minkowski matrix. This is the name given this distance matrix. There are different types of matrix, so you have to remember the formulas. This is one formula for calculating Minkowski matrix. These properties of finding the Minkowski matrix are very, very important from exam point of view. And we can apply, actually, we can apply this same properties to all the different matrix that we use to calculate the distances between two points. They are same for all matrix. The first important property of this matrix is that non-negativity. The distance must be positive. So what is non-negativity? You can express it by two lines. One is where d of x comma y is greater than or equal to zero for all x and y. It means the distance between two points must always be positive for all the x and y's. Then the distance of x comma y may be zero or equal to zero if and only if both the points are same. X and y, both the objects are same. This is called as identity condition. When the distance becomes zero, when both are same, this is called as identity condition. Then symmetry property. Symmetry property says that d of x comma y is equal to d of y comma x for all x and y. This condition measures that the order in which objects are considered is not important. It means that you can write x comma y or you can write y comma x. We are bothered about only the distance. If it is same, we can say that it is symmetric. Both the points are symmetric. The order is not important into this symmetric property. Third important property is called as transitivity. You might have studied this transitivity property in properties of triangles in standard 6th or 7th. And the same property is again there here. That is called as transitivity property. What is transitivity property? Suppose there are three sides of a triangle pointed by the points x, y and z. So what are the sides of the triangle? X comma z, x comma y and y comma z. There are three sides, suppose. The distance of x comma z is always less than or equal to distance of x comma y plus distance of y comma z. It means that distance of any side which is having less distance is always less than the addition of two sides, distance of two sides, or a side which is very small is always less than the addition of two sides of a triangle. This condition has the interpretation that the least distance that is d of x comma z between two objects x and z is always less than or equal to the sum of distances between the two objects x and y and between y and z. If you draw a triangle, you get three sides xz, xy and yz. So when you apply this property, definitely distance of xz is less than the distance of x comma y plus the distance of y comma z. This property is also termed as triangular inequality property. Triangle inequality property. So this property you have studied in the standard 6 and 7. Properties of triangles. Okay. Then another point about proximity measures for internal scale. Depending on the value of r, the distance measure is renamed accordingly. One of the distance measure can be Manhattan distance, where it is also called as L1 norm, where r value is 1. This we are going to use in calculating the other distances like Euclidean distance. This formula I am going to use to calculate Euclidean distance also. So to understand Euclidean distance, before that we need to understand what Manhattan distance and what is the formula to calculate the Manhattan distance. Manhattan distance is expressed as the formula d equal to summation of all the objects, differences of all the objects, where I equal to 1, it goes till n, and determinant of xi minus yi, where y, this determinant is represented by two vertical lines in the formula, which gives you the absolute value of the difference point. This matrix is also alternatively termed as taxical matrix or city block matrix. It means that the Manhattan distance is also termed as taxical matrix or city block matrix. In an example, they may give you x and y. They give you two values. It may be vector, it may be point, it may be string, or it may be anything. So your job is to find Manhattan distance between two points. So if you see, this is an example given here. X is having the values 7, 3, 5 in the set, whereas y is having the value 3, 2, and 6. Then to find the Manhattan distance, I will take the determinant of x comma x minus y. So if I consider 7 as x1, 3 as x2, 5 as x3. Similarly, y set, it is y1, y2, y3. To get the first determinant value, I will use x1 minus y1, x2 minus y2, x3 minus y3. So the formula of Manhattan distance becomes determinant of 7 minus 3 plus determinant of 3 minus 2 plus determinant of 5 minus 6. Why the determinant is given? It is but obvious because the distance must be positive. So whatever the answer of this determinant comes inside, it may be negative or positive, determinant will make it positive. It always gives the positive value. So 7 minus 3 is 4. That's why the answer for first term is 4. Second term is 3 minus 2 is 1. And the last one is again 1. So 4 plus 1 plus 1, it goes to 6. So the Manhattan distance for this point is 6. A special instance of Manhattan distance where attribute values are in the terms of bits. What is the bit value? Bit value may be 0 or it may be 1. Then such Manhattan distance is also called as Hamming distance. Hamming distance always deals with the bits. It does not deal with any other objects. So whenever the attribute values are in terms of 0 and 1, then Manhattan distance in that situation is called as Hamilton distance. Alternatively, Hamilton distance is the number of bits that are different between two objects that have only binary values between two binary vectors. Then the important point is Euclidean distance. How to find the Euclidean distance? This matrix is same as Euclidean distance between any two points like x and y in Rn. Okay. So how to calculate that we have a formula, that is d of x comma y is equals to under root of summation of I equal to 1 to n in bracket xi minus yi square, right? So we are going to put the value inside this formula to obtain the Euclidean distance, and that can be also be represented by L2 norm here. Consider there are two values given to you, two points given to you, x and y. Same example is given here. X is having the value 7, 3, 5, and y is having the value 3, 2, and 6. And you have to find the Euclidean distance between x and y. To find that, we will use the formula d of x, comma y equals to under root of, what is this, 7 minus 3 is x1 minus y1. What is x1? It is 7. y1 is 3. Then x2 minus y2. x2 is 3. y2 is 2. x3 is 5. y2 is 6. So we put those values. 7 minus 3 is bracket score. 3 minus 2 bracket score. 5 minus 6 the bracket score. We need to solve this now. So the answer of the first term inside the under root is 4 square. Then 1 square. Then 1 square. 4 square is 16. 16 plus 1 plus 1. Total goes to 18. Under root of 18 is approximately comes to 2.426. It comes to 2.426. So this type of question may be asked for 5 marks in your examination. So we have seen two types of proximity measures for internal scale. One is Manhattan distance and another is Euclidean distance. Now third one is Chebyshev distance, or it is also called as L infinity norm. It is also called as L infinity norm, where R belongs to capital R. How to find the this distance? We have the formula D equal to max of all these values inside this set, xi, determinant of xi minus yi. Again, we'll take the same example to find this distance. First of all, we'll find the Manhattan distance. For this, it is similar to the previous example. It is 7 minus 3, determinant of 7 minus 3 plus determinant of 3 minus 2 plus determinant of 5 minus 6, and it is obtained as 6. If I find the Chebyshev distance between these things, then I will apply just a max function on the above set. That is, set consists of the values determinant of 7 minus 3 comma determinant of 3 minus 2 determinant of 5 minus 6. Out of this, all this, your answer comes as max of 4 comma 1 comma 1. Out of these three entities, which is the maximum value? It is 4. That's why the L infinity norms result is 4. So you have to remember these three distance norms. We have seen first one is L1 norm, Manhattan distance. Second is L2 norms, it is Euclidean distance. Third is L infinity norm, it is Chebyshev distance, right? So these three we are going to use in some of the problem solving of